Hello, my name is Greg Pritchard, and I am Lower Merion Township's Historic Preservation Planner. Today, I would like to share a very rare and special film with you. In the mid-1960s, Philadelphia's WFIL-TV, which was then Channel 6, produced a weekly series of programs they called Community Salutes, half-hour programs highlighting various towns in our region. WFIL filmed several of these programs right here in Lower Merion. We first learned about them when three films in engraved presentation canisters labeled Lower Merion Township, Bryn Mawr, and Haverford found their way to the Building and Planning Department through a resident who kept them safe for many years. Now, this particular film that you're about to see is the Salute to Lower Merion Township, which first aired on WFIL the week of April 4th, 1966.
The WFIL stations are proud to salute Lower Merion Township, this splendid community of more than 24 square miles in which live some 65,000 people, is many things within itself. Primarily, the township is a residential area of great beauty. Some of the most lovely homes and estates in Montgomery County are located in the township. Yet this complex of communities presents endless variety of endeavor and startling progress. We've said Lower Merion Township is largely homes, and it is. Some are stately, others attractive with modest charm. In almost every neighborhood, trees and shrubbery have been carefully preserved. There's no clutter of jumbled houses shoving elbows at adjoining properties. Lawns, even in wintertime and early spring, show care and interest. The township has been most wise in effecting ordinances assuring harmonious development. In each segment of its confines, land subdivision regulations pertain. These requirements coordinate proposed streets with existing arteries, provide open space, and make certain ample recreational acreage is laid out. A township shade tree bureau has done a fine job of preserving the green tunnels that make the area an outstanding example of valid livability. The quaint English village proves originality of architectural concept has not been neglected. Township government sets a pattern of excellence. Hal L. Bemis, president of the Board of Commissioners.
John, the problems of Lower Merion, and so far as the future is concerned, are the problems that face any suburban area located adjacent to a major urban center, in this case, of course, Philadelphia. Historically, Lower Merion has been, and to a large extent is, a suburban area of living. And yet the problems here are those that are increasing population, increasing urbanization of the entire surroundings, and we have to face up to these facts. We have to be able to live with them and yet still keep the character of the community as our citizens would like to have it. Now, these problems are not insoluble. They merely mean that we have to look at things in a different context. We are not what we were 50 years ago, a rather pleasant, in a large sense, farming rural area. We are a major center, and we have to consider our police, our fire, our refuse collections, our sewage, all the other things that a city would do. And yet we live under a legal concept of government, which is a township. Now, we are moving in these directions. We are finding ways to solve these problems, and I think we're going to find the way to do them quite successfully. We can do so as long as these are the things that our citizens want, and I'm satisfied that that's what they do. They want Lower Merion to be an outstanding township, an outstanding suburban area, and contribute to the life of the community and of the region in this fashion. And I'm sure that that through their commissioners, they'll be able to find these solutions in the future. There seems to be no question in my mind that we are moving in this direction and moving successfully.
Dozens of churches of all denominations dot Lower Merion Township. All are well attended. Religion is important, congregations faithful, secular activities are strongly supported. Each portion of the township cherishes its houses of worship. Despite duplication of sect, Actually, Lower Merion is a sort of collection of communities. Ardmore, North Ardmore, Wynwood, South Wynwood, Penn Wynn, Merion, Narberth, Ballachinwood, Pencoy, General Wayne, Haverford, East and West Bryn Mawr, Rosemont, and Gladwin all have their churches. The structure and being of a community is usually measured by spiritual interest found within it. The township is rich in this blessing, always has been. That it has prospered since inception is reflected in duty to and reverence for God. The Gladwin Playground is only a portion of the township's 450 acres devoted to healthful recreation, a fulsome summer program supervised by adult leader services, all age groups from mid-May to mid-August. The Philadelphia Country Club offers a more sophisticated form of pleasure for its more than 1,000 members on a fine 18-hole golf course. The club, which is world-famous in golfdom and tastefully decorated within, has been in existence since 1890. Youngsford Valley Park, along with other areas, have been left in a natural state for nature lovers. Assistant Township Manager Thomas Fulweiler.
The township has 448 acres of parks, playgrounds, and botanical gardens. In addition, there are 168 acres of play areas available at the various township schools. The parks and playgrounds offer a diversified range of facilities for the active athlete, the spectator, the passive observer of nature, and those merely interested in enjoying the benefits of open space in this rapidly urbanizing area. On the drawing boards are plans to develop some 12 acres recently acquired by Township along the Schuylkill River to be known as Flat Rock Park. Here it is hoped that boating, picnicking, and fishing facilities will be made available.
Lower Merion Township possesses a modern and salutary school system with 9 elementary schools, 3 junior high schools, and 2 high schools. The township for many years has enjoyed an enviable reputation for the caliber and performance of its teachers and students. Area schools rank high among all of the school districts in the United States. Enrollment is approximately 10,000 pupils. Lower Merion Senior High School, Ardmore, is a big educational installation. Some 1,450 students attend. Most graduates go on to institutions of higher learning. William T. Bean is principal at this senior high. Robert M. Ruoff, assistant principal. The school is proud of a fine new swimming pool. Ed Conrad is the director of swimming. He told us, "It's our desire to teach everyone to swim before graduation, plus the attributes of physical fitness." The pool is divided into a 75 by 42 foot instructional area and a 42 by 27 diving space with 2 1-meter boards. Swimming classes are held throughout the day. Lower Merion's curricula read like a college course list. There's infinite variety from world geography to economic analysis and auto mechanics. Of course, standard educational requirements receive full attention. Waldron Academy for Boys is one of Lower Merion Township's fine parochial institutions. Adjacent is Mater Misericordia School for Girls. The two are administered by the Sisters of Mercy. St. Charles Borromeo Catholic Seminary on Lancaster Pike and City Line is exquisitely designed to inspire both reverence and holy learning. Across the pike stands the Eastern Baptist Theological Seminary, architecture of a different but no less attractive sort and as inspirational. Bryn Mawr in the township is almost a capital of feminine higher education. Harcum Junior College burgeons with new buildings and ambitious plans for more of the same. Harcum is more than a half a century old. Shipley School was founded in 1894 by three Quaker gentlewomen. Here, young ladies are prepared for college in a pleasant social atmosphere where scholarship is absorbed amid congenial surroundings. Shipley, too, has embarked on a substantial construction program. Another of Bryn Mawr's salient institutions of learning is Baldwin, founded in 1888 to ready young ladies for college admission. Total enrollment of day and boarding students is about 500. The main building was once a fashionable hotel. Bryn Mawr College represents the growth of an idea nurtured by a New Jersey doctor in 1885. Dr. Joseph Taylor's gift of his estate and the institution's initial buildings has flowered beyond his wildest dreams to become one of the nation's most distinguished women's colleges. It's a beautiful place. Lower Merion Township is fortunate in having first-rate medical services. Mr. H.W. Mason, director of Lankenau Hospital.
We feel that no township in Pennsylvania has health services superior to Lower Merion. Our Board of Health, so capably directed by Dr. Stuart Polk, supervises the enforcement of one of the most comprehensive health codes in the state. Its emphasis is on the prevention of disease. Supporting the Board of Health in its work are two other agencies, the local office of the Pennsylvania Department of Health and the Community Health and Civic Association. A third agency, the Family Service of the Main Line, concerns itself with the mental and sociological health of the community. If hospitalization is necessary, our township offers first-rate medical facilities. The township's two hospitals, Bryn Mawr and Lankenau, are noted for superior patient care and outstanding resources. The two hospitals have a combined capacity of more than 750 beds and 90 bassinets. Last year, they admitted over 25,000 patients for a total of almost 230,000 patient days. Their accident wards cared for more than 35,000 emergency cases, and their outpatient clinics numbered over 40,000 visits from patients unable to afford the care of a private physician. The facilities at Bryn Mawr and Lankenau Hospitals provide medical care not only for the residents of Lower Merion Township, but also serve a large section of the greater metropolitan area.
Lankenau is renowned for its medical developments. One is the science of ergocardiography, in which an ailing or healthy heart is tested while the patient is actively occupied. The word ergocardiography is coined from the Greek ergon, meaning work, and cardiography, the recording of the heart's movements. Electrodes are attached under the supervision of Mrs. Merritt Schumann, research assistant, with technicians Diana DiGregorio and Rosalind Minker. The patient pedals a stationary bicycle at different workloads. Readings are taken and diagnoses eventually made. The situation is comparable to testing an airplane engine while it takes off. In the air or on the ground, the engine's performance is not always a true estimate of its required capability. Ergocardiography embraces the same principle. Before Lankenau's singular development, the heart could only be tested while at rest or after exercise. Blanche Day of Lankenau's administration staff showed us the hospital's fascinating health museum, the first of its kind in the nation. Lankenau regards itself as a center for positive health, not merely as a good repair shop for injured bodies. This was a fascinating place. Bryn Mawr Hospital serves not only Lower Merion Township, but wide areas of the Delaware Valley and the nation. Lower Merion Township is steeped in early American history. Here and there, old buildings such as this branch library still stand. Appropriately, this old-fashioned hardware store offers rare items from yesterday. Browsing's encouraged, whether a toboggan, teapot, or hooked rug is desired. Lower Merion had its beginnings way back in 1609 when Captain Henry Hudson explored the region. 1681 saw a permanent settlement established by Welsh Quakers on a grant from William Penn. The General Wayne Inn was built in 1704, suffered a disastrous fire in 1965, is now reopened. Lancaster Pike cuts across an important corner of the township. The roadway, much of its length crowded with busy shops, is an important mercantile artery. There are not many things, from automobiles to fine paintings, that cannot be purchased somewhere along the way. The economic climate of Lower Merion is healthy. Stores and businesses appear to flourish. The small outlet seems predominant, but there are a few big industries in the area. Good taste and reasonable price ranges is a byword. High fashion or supply for the larder go hand in hand along the pike. Mainline Chamber of Commerce President James P. Owens, Jr.
The Mainline Chamber of Commerce was founded in 1921 and serves the area from City Line to Malvern. Its 45 years of operation has seen much progress in this ever-expanding area. Although not an industrial area, it has developed into a strong residential area where service types of business has prospered. It is the purpose of the Mainline Chamber of Commerce to sustain and further progress through the work of active vigilant committees. It is made up of more than 450 active commercial, industrial, and professional men and women who volunteer their services and play an influential and diversified role in our development. At present, we are involved in Operation Progress in Bryn Mawr, a program to revitalize the older business areas by modernizing storefronts and modernizing interiors and providing more parking to make this a more attractive place in which to shop.
Lower Merion Township residents rely on their local government. One reason why they can is Township Manager and Secretary John F. Scull, Jr.
The job of managing the Township of Lower Merion is one of great interest because of the many facilities and facets that are involved. The act of coordinating the various phases of local government, such as your police department, your fire department, the Board of Health, the Building Regulations Department, our recreation program, the collection of rubbish and trash, and the highway program is one of very great complexity and of much interest to all of us. The idea of compiling the records and keeping the work of the various departments coordinated with the policies as laid down by the Board of Commissioners of the Township of Lower Merion, a body of 14 men, is one of some difficulty, but of great interest because of the fact that we always are working continuously with the great number of the citizens of the community. Our community of some 65,000 people is interested in our work, and we enjoy it.
Security in the township is a careful consideration. Superintendent of Police, G. Andrew McLaughlin.
The police department of the township of Lower Merion is made up of 118 sworn police officers plus 15 civilians. This department maintains a very adequate security patrol, and particularly by reason of the fact that we are located immediately adjacent to the large city of Philadelphia. The majority of crime committed in this township is committed by persons living in areas other than our township itself. During the year 1966, the police department received and processed some 18,000 complaints of all natures. Included in this total were 1,421 accident reports as a result of investigations involving 4 fatalities and 607 injuries. Traffic continues to be a major problem for law enforcement. During the year 1966, the department will go through a period of reorganization of personnel and will institute a new communication system. By reason of this reorganization, we will better serve the people of Lower Merion Township.
One of the most remarkable industries in the country has been doing business in Rosemont for many a decade. The Durham Custom Body Company started in 1887. Enos Durham showed us a 1931 Aston Martin sports phaeton with bicycle fenders. All we could think of was the indefatigable James Bond, even though he favored the Bentley. This wonderful automobile from yesterday is in mint condition and is worth in the neighborhood of from $30,000 to $35,000. Durham is one of the few remaining custom bodybuilders in the country. This is the place where dreams on wheels come to life. Where the millionaire or proud potentate may indulge any and all of his automotive fancies. Durham is also a staunch citadel of magnificent automotive engineering and design surpassing imagination. Durham is an institution, an aristocrat that makes Detroit look plebeian. It was how Durham began as a carriage maker on Lancaster Pike near the turn of the century. Once Durham built the finest carriages on the main line, this was the display room where only the best was procurable. The company has supplied presidential vehicles. This one was used by President Eisenhower. Pope Pius XII had the firm construct a comfortable office in the back seat of the papal automobile. The Sheikh of Kuwait demanded an all-pink car 2 feet longer than an auto owned by a neighboring ruler. New York's Grover Whalen had this car built by Durham for Broadway ticker tape parades. The late Gary Cooper had Durham build him a special Duesenberg. A 1930 Mercedes is under explicit restoration. Durham has done special jobs for many African, Asian, and South American people of prominence. It's a glamour business with orders in the past from the King of England, Farouk of Egypt, Cuban sugar monarchs, American railroad magnates, even a car ordered through Amtorg for Joseph Stalin. Sheer romance on rubber. What a business. Durham, a name never to forget if you love wheels. Civic interests bloom in Lower Merion Township. Mrs. Mark Baran, president of the League of Women Voters.
The League of Women Voters is a nonpartisan organization whose purpose is to promote the informed and active participation of citizens in government. We have a twofold function in Lower Merion. First, through our voter service campaigns, we encourage the participation of all citizens in government through register and vote campaigns. We circulate to every voting family in the township a copy of our voter's guide before every election. This guide provides nonpartisan information on candidates and issues to be voted on in that election. A second part of our efforts is to take action on particular items of interest. This follows a period of sustained study by the membership of the League and a consensual agreement on particular stands. In this township, we have engaged in action on our local tax. We urge the uniform assessments in this township. We have urged a full tax base for our libraries, and we have a stand on county child welfare. We also have many stands under the general area of civil rights in education and in housing. We are also engaged in the study at this point of our recreation and open space and of our local government structure. Following the period of study, we hope to come to consensus in these areas, and we will then take action.
The Decker Corporation at one end of Lower Merion Township in Ballack-Kinwood manufactures electronic instrumentation. Martin M. Decker, company president, has branched out in unbounded ambition, and more about that in a moment. The Decker firm supplied instruments for our military and for medical use, and still does. The people who work here go about their duties in the same hushed reverence one finds in a top-flight research laboratory. The perfecting of delicate measuring machines, the handicraft and know-how stir admiration. This is a quiet place where science and ingenuity are married in congenial skill. We're all at sea, but for the electronic engineer, Decker makes delta units and monitors, non-contact gauges, solid-state transducers, and probes. Mysterious ways of science, but they know what they're doing. The Decker line has played a signal part in the scientific advances we enjoy today, not only for our military security, but in industry and medicine. Decker represents a milepost of progress in the world of practical science. Martin Decker is endowed with daring imagination. Instrumentation, relatively, is minute. Decker's ambitions as a developer are huge. Decker Square, 7 minutes from Philadelphia, is taking shape. This enterprising dreamer has already finished the plush 191 apartments, a true showplace of luxurious living. But 191 is only part of an immense building plan encompassing 65 acres. When all is done, the area will include 6 office buildings, a computer center, an air-conditioned mall with shops, 2 theaters, an auditorium, a landscape rooftop, recreation plaza, and parking for more than 5,300 cars. We have said Lower Merion Township is many things. The so-called Golden Mile proves the point. In short years, high-rise apartments, elaborate office buildings, and company headquarters have sprung from what once was woodland. The complex is attractive, a sort of monumental gateway to the fine living deeper in the township. If there be paradox in what has happened, the changes made do much to enhance Lower Merion status, certainly from a tax standpoint. The beauty of the Golden Mile, with its neatly arranged Ballack-Kinwood shopping center containing 2 large stores and some 30 shops, is patently clear. The WFIL-TV salute team, Bill Lawrence, and I enjoyed our visit to Lower Merion Township. We were struck with its many attractive facets, its wisdom of development, its many sides and moves. We admired the efficiency of local government, the preservation of outstanding residential tracts. This is John Roth.
We would like to thank the Broadcast Pioneers of Philadelphia and Temple University's TU-TV for their help digitizing these films. The quality at which we can now see them is even better than when they were first broadcast. We hope you enjoy seeing what our community was like more than 50 years ago.